τι τον δείξαν δι το φως, δόξα εν υψίστης Θεό, και επί γης ειρήνη εν ανθρώπης ευδοκία.
Υμνούμεν σε, ευλογούμεν σε, προσκυνούμεν σε, δοξολογούμεν σε, ευχαριστούμεν σε, δια την μεγάλην σου δόξα.
Κύριε Βασίλευ, επουράνιε Θεέ, Πατέρ Παντοκράτων, Κύριε Ιε μονογενές, Ιησού Χριστέ και Αγίον Πνεύμα.
Κύριε ο Θεός, ο άμνος του Θεού, ο Υιός του Πατρός, ο αίρον την αμαρτίαν του κόσμου, ελέησον ημάς, ο αίρον τας αμαρτίας του κόσμου.
Πρόσδεξε την δέησιν ημών, ο καθήμενος εν δεξιά του Πατρός, ελέησον ημάς.
Ότι σήμωνος Άγιος, σήμωνος Κύριος, Ιησούς Χριστός εις δόξαν Θεού Πατρός αμή.
Καθεκάστην ημέραν ευλογήσωσε και ενέσω το όνομα σου εις τον αιώνα και εις τον αιώνα του αιώνα.
Καταξίωσον Κύριε εν τη ημέρα ταύτη, αναμαρτήτους φυλαχθήνε ημάς.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε ο Θεός των Πατέρων ημών και ενετών και δεδοξασμένον το όνομά σου εις τους αιώνας αμήν.
Γέννητο Κύριε το ελέον σου εφημάς, καθά περιλπίσαμεν επίσε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Κύριε καταφυγή εγεννήθης ημίν εν γενναία και γενναία, εγώ είπα Κύριε ελέησον με, ίασε την ψυχή μου ότι ημαρτώνσι.
Κύριε προσέκατε φυγόν, δίδαξον με το ποιή το θέλημά σου, ότι εσύ ο Θεός μου.
Ότι παρασύ πηγή ζωής, εν το φωτί σου οψώμεθα φως.
Παρατηνών το ελαιός σου της γήνος κουσίσε, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι.
Εν ειν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς. Oh.
σωτηρία τον κόσμο γέγονε. Άσομεν το Αναστάντη εκ τάφου και αρχηγό τη ζωή ημών. Αθελόγαρ το θάνατο των θάνατων, τον οίκος εδώ και ημί και το μεγά ελέω.
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Υπέρ της ειρηνίας του σύμπαντος κόσμος, του Θεού, του Θεού, του Θεού Εκκλησιών, και της των πάντων ενώσεως του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Υπέρ του Αρχιεπισκόπου ημών Νικολάου του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτερίου της εν Χριστώ Διακονίας, πάντως του κλήρου και του λαού του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For the President of the United States, for those in civil authority, for the armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Υπέρ της Ιεράς Μετροπόλεως καινουρίας ταύτης και πάσης πόλεως μονής και χώρας και των πιστικούντων ναύτες του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have
mercy. For deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός, τη συγχωρητή. Memory to the most holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Πρέπει εις η πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκύνηση στο Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Εξηρεύξα το η καρδία μου λόγων αγαθών.
Ο Λόρα Γάρους δημιουργείς εγκατσίβαπο. Grant this to those who pray with us, thy abundant mercies and compassions.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, save us.
Εξεχέθη χάρις εν τυχήλες
Δεσπεθίας εις Θεοτόκου, σώθε σώσον ημάς.
Again and again in peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Is the dominion, thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Bless the Lord our God, save thy people, and bless thy inheritance, protect the whole body of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy temple. Granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth and the hope to come life everlasting. And in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life. Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thou, God, art holy and good and lovest mankind, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Αυτή η μέρα, Κυρίου, αγαλιασούμεθα και φρανθούμεν εν αυτή, ούτε κάτι ήρθες προς τον θάνατον, η ζωή αθάνατος, τότε τον αδύνενε, αστραπή της θεότητος, ούτε δε
Μάρτυρας Χριστού, οικετεύσομεν πάντες, αυτοί γαρτήν ημών σωτηρίαν ετούνται, και πάντες προσέλθομεν προς αυτούς μεταπίστεως, ούτι βρίουσιν των ιαμάτων την χάρη, ούτι φάλαγγας αποσοβούσι δαιμόνων ως φύλακες της πίστεως.
Την πανεπιμόν υπή Χριστού υμνήσομεν, εκατερίναν την Θείαν και πολιούχον σύνα, την βοήθειαν ημών και αντίληψη, ότι εφήμως ελάμπρος τους κόψους των ασεβών του πνεύματος τη δύναμη, γεννήνος μάρτης τεθήσα, ετήτε πάση, το μεγά ελέος.
Μνήσθητη, Κύριε, ως αγαθός των δούλων σου, και όσα εν βίω ημαρτών συγχωρείς, ουδείς γαράν αμάρτητος, η μισίω δύναμε και της μεταστάση δούνε την ανάπαση.
Γεννήσει τη Παρθενή η ανεφύλαξος, εν τη θυμίσει τον κόσμο που κατέληπες Θεοτόκε, μετέστης προς τη ζωής, ή τη παρούσα της ζωής, και τες πρεσβείες τες θέλης.
Septin su icona porta itis adespina, ilia thalassis epesti thavmastos endipinisu, timomen os agias masepton, testino matis doxisu pistos, ex aftis garan avisis tas doreas, tis potho equosisi, δόξα τις θαυμασί σου αγνή, δόξα τη προμηθεία σου, δόξα τη προσημά σου πλουσία Χριστότητη.
Ο μήτραν παρθενικήν αγιάσας το τόκο σου
και χείρας του Σημαίων ευλογήσας ως έπρεπε.
Προφθάσας καινήν έσωσας ημάς Χριστέ ο Θεός.
Αλληρήνευσον εν πολέμης το πολιτεύμα
και κρατέωσον βασιλίσους ηγάπησας
ο μόνος φιλάνθρωπος.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison.
For thou, God, art holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Adios, O Theos. Adios, Isiros. Adios, Apharatos.
Γέννητε Κύριε του Ελεός εφ' ημάς, αγαλλιάστε δίκαιε εν Κυρίως.
Σοφία.
Προς Κορινθίους πρώτης επιστολής Παύλου, ο ανάγνωσμα.
Προσκομέ.
Αδελφοί, Panda mi existin, au panda sinferi. Panda mi existin, au prego exosiastisome ipotinos. Τα βρώματα και κοιλία, της βρώμασιν, ο δε Θεός και ταύτην και ταύτα καταργήσει. Το δε σώμα ούτη πορνεία, αλλά το Κυρίο και ο Κύριος το σώματι. Ο δε Θεός και τον Κύριον ήγηρε και ημάς εξεγερεί δια της δυνάμεως αυτού. Ούκ είδατε ότι τα σώματα ημών μέλη Χριστού εστίν, άρας ούν τα μέλη του Χριστού πίσω πόρνης μέλη μη γέννητο. Ούκ είδατε ότι ο κολόμενος τη πόρνη εν σώμα εστίν, έσονται γάρφοι σύν οι δύο οι σάρκα μίαν, ο δε κολόμενος το Κυρίο εν πνεύμα εστί. Φεύγετε την πορνείαν, παναμάρτημα ο εάν ποιήσει άνθρωπος εκτός του σώματος εστίν, ο δε πορνεύον εις το ίδιον σώμα αμαρτάνει. Ιουκ είδατε ότι το σώμα ημών ναός του εν ημίν Αγίου Πνεύματος εστίν, ου έχετε από Θεού και ουκ εστέ εαυτόν. Υγοράστητε γάρ τιμής, δοξάσατε δε τον Θεόν εν το σώμα τιμών. Και εν το πνεύμα τιμών, άτινα εστί του Θεού.
Let us attend.
Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us. Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous.
Christo.
The reading is from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, all things are lawful for me, but not all things are helpful. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be enslaved by anything. Food is meant for the stomach, and the stomach for food. And God will destroy both one and the other. The body is not meant for immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And God raised the Lord, and will also raise us up by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? Shall I therefore take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that he who joins himself to a prostitute becomes one body with her? For as it is written, the two shall become one flesh. But he who is united to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Shun immorality. Every other sin which a man commits is outside the body, but the immoral man sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God? You are not your own. You were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which belong to God.
Peace be with you. Ακούσμεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πάση. Ήρτου καταλογών Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα ο Κύριος την παραβολήν ταύτην, άνθρωπος της είχε δύο υιούς, και είπεν ο νεότερος αυτόν το πατρί, «Πάτερ, δώσμι το επιβάλλον μέρος της ουσίας», και δήλεν αυτής το βίον. Και μετού πολλάς ημέρας συναγωγών, άπαντα ο νεότερος γιος, απεδήμησεν εις χώραν μακράν, και εκεί διεσκόρπισε την ουσίαν αυτού ζων ασώτος. Δαπανίσαντος δε αυτού πάντα εγένετο λοιμός ισχυρός κατά την χώραν εκείνην, και αυτός ήρξατο ιστηρίστε, και πορευθείς εκολύθη ενή των πολιτών της χώρας εκείνης κέμπεμψεν αυτόν και εις τους αγρούς αυτού βόσκην χείρους. Και επιθύμη γεμίσε την κοιλίαν αυτού από τον κερατίον την ίσθησον η χείρη και οδείς εδίδου αυτό. Εις εαυτόν δε ελθόν είπε, πόση μίσθη του πατρός μου περισσεύουσιν άρτων, εγώ δε λοιμώ απόλυμε. Αναστάς πορεύσομαι προς τον πατέρ μου, καιρό αυτό πάτερ ήμαρτον εις των ουρανών και ενωπιών σου, ουκέτι ήμι άξιος κληθήνε γιο σου, πίσον με ως ένα των μυστείων σου. Και Αναστάς ήλθε προς τον πατέρα αυτού, έτιδε αυτού μακράν απέχοντος, είδε αυτόν ο πατήρ αυτού και ευσπλακνίστη και δραμών ενέπεσεν επί των τράχυλων αυτού και καταφύλησεν αυτόν. Είπε δε αυτού ο Υιός, Πάτερ ήμαρτον εις των ουρανών και ενωπιών σου, και ουκέτι είμαι άξιος κληθήνε γιο σου. Είπε δε ο πατήρ προς τους δούλους σου, εξενέγατε την στολήν την πρώτην και δίσατε αυτόν, και δότε δακτύλιον εις την χείρα αυτού και υποδήματα εις τους πόδας και νέγκαντες των μόσκων την συντευτών, θύσατε και φαγόντες εφρανθόμεν, ότι ούτως ο γιος μου νεχρός ειν και ανέζησε και απολωλός ειν και βρέθη. Και ήρξατο, εφρενέστε, ειν δε γιος αυτού ο πρεσβύτερος εν αγρό και ως ερχόμενος ίγγισε τη οικία είκοσε συμφωνίας και χωρών και προσκαλεσάμενος ένα των παιδών ενεθάνωτο και ή ταύτα. Ο δε είπεν αυτό ότι ο αδελφός σου οίκει και ίστησεν ο πατήρ σου των μόσκων των συτευτών και γιένονται αυτών απέλευεν οργίστη δε και ουκ η θέλησεν εισελθήν. Ο ούν πατήρ αυτού εξελθών παρακάλλει αυτόν, ο δε αποκριθείς είπε το πατρί, ιδού το σαύτα έτι δουλεύω σύ και ουδέποτε εντολήν την παρήλθον και μη ουδέποτε έδωκες έρηφον, είναι μετά των φίλων μου εφρανθώ, ότι δε ο Υιός σου ούτως, ο καταφαγών σου και βίων μετά πορνών, ήρθεν έθισας αυτών των μόσκων των συτευτών. Ο δε είπε αυτό, τέκνον σι πάντοτε, μετεμούι και πάντα τα εμάκεστην, εφρανθήνε δε και χαρίνε λέει, ότι ο αδελφός σου ούτως νεκρός είναι και ανέζησε. Απολωλώσιν και βρέθη.
The reading is taken from the Gospel according to Saint Luke. Let us be attentive. The Lord said this parable. There was a man who had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the share of the property that belongs and falls to me. And he divided his living between them. And not many days later, the younger son gathered all that he had and took his journey into a far country. And there he squandered his property in loose living. And when he had spent everything, a great famine arose in that country, and he began to be in want. So he went and joined himself to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into the fields to feed the swine. And he would gladly have fed on the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything more. But when the younger son came to himself finally, he said, "How many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, but I perish here with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Therefore, treat me as one of your hired servants.' And he arose and came to his father. But while he was yet at a distance, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and embraced him and kissed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to the servants, 'Bring quickly the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet, and bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry. For this my son was dead and now is alive again. He was lost and is now found.' And they began to make merry. Now his elder son was still in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. And he called one of the servants and asked what this meant. And he said to him, 'Your brother has returned, and your father has killed the fatted calf because he has received him safe and sound.' But the older son was angry and refused to go in. His father came out and entreated him, but he answered his father, 'Lo, these many years I have served you faithfully, and I never disobeyed your command. Yet you never gave me a kid that I might make merry with my friends. But when this son of yours came, who has devoured your living with harlots, you killed for him the fatted calf.' And the father said to him, 'Son, you are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. For it is fitting to make merry and be glad. For this your brother was dead and is now alive. He is lost, but now is found.'" Protected by thy power, to thee we may ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Desires and pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach or draw near, to serve thee, O King of Glory. For to serve thee is great and awesome, even to the heavenly powers, yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind, thou dost unchangeably and immutably become man. Serve thee, God's high priest, and as Lord of all, has committed to us the celebration of the liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. For thou alone, our Lord, our God, rulest over all things in heaven and earth, who art born on the throne of the cherubim, and Lord and seraphim, King of Israel. Who alone art holy and rest among thy saints, wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant. Cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience, and enable me by the power of the Holy Spirit, blessed the grace of the priesthood, to stand before this, thy holy altar, and consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood. For to thee I come, having bowed my head and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither reject from among thy children. Make me worthy, thy sinful and unworthy servant, to offer these gifts unto thee. For thou art the offer, the accepted distributor of Christ our God, and to whom ascribe glory, and to thee who ascribe glory together with our eternal Father, by the light of the Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Thank you. May the Lord our God remember us all in his heavenly kingdom. Now, to the ages of ages. For these precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Ημέρον πάσαν τελείαν Αγίαν ελληνικήν και αμάρτητον παρά του Κυρίου ετ ισόμεθα. For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. For the forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. For things that are good and profitable unto our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remainder of our lives in peace and penitence, let us ask of the Lord. The end of our lives may be Christian, without pain, blameless and peaceful, and for a good account at the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. In our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Ιατονίκτην μόντου Μαριανού σου Υιού με θου ευλογητός εις ειν το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύμα την ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας. Love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Ave Maria,
Τας τυρας εν σοφία πρόσκομεν.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεό, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης, ορατών δε πάντων
και ουράτων,
και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησού Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού, τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός γεννηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων. Πόσο υποτός, Θεόν αληθινόν εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννηθέντα, ούπι θέντα, ομοούσιον το Πατρίδιου τα πάντα εγένετο. Τον δημάς τους ανθρώπους, για την μετέρα σωτηρία, καταρθώντα εκ των ουρανών, σακωθέντα εκ Πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας Παρθένου την ανθρωπίσοντα. Σταυρωθέντα το υπερημόν, επί ποντίου Πιλάτου και παθώντα και τα φέντα, και αναστάντα την τρίτη ημέρα κατά τα γραφάς. Και ανελθώντα εις τους ουρανούς και κατεζόμενο εκ δεξιών του Πατρός, και πάλι ερχόμενο με τα δόξης, κρίνε ζώντας και νεκρούς, ούτ της βασιλείας, ούτ και στο τέλος. Και εις το Πνεύμα το Άγιο, το Κύριο, το Ζώπιο, το εκ του Πατρός εκπορευόμενο, το Συμπατρί και Υιό συνδοσκυνούμενο και συνδοξαζόμενο, το λαλήσαν πλάτων προφητών. Εις μίαν Αγία, καθολητήν και αποστολητήν εκκλησία, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν στην αμαρτιών, προσδοκώ Ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωή του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Στόμεν καλό, στόμεν με το φόβο, πρόσκομεν την Αγία αναφοράν εν ειρήνη προσφέρει. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord. Τον επινίκειον ύμνον άδοντα φόντα και κραγώτα και λέγοντα
disciples and apostles saying,
Sana and
Σώμα του επέριμον κολόμενον, εις άφησιν αμάρτιον. Take ye, eat, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins. Likewise the cup after the supper, saying, Ιεδ εξ αυτού πάντες, τούτο εστί το αίμα μου το της καινής διαθήκης, το επέριμον και παλών ευκοινόμενον εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον. Drink from it, ye all. This is my blood of the New Testament, which for you and for many is shed, unto remission of sins. Remembering this command of our Savior and all that endured for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sitting at the right hand, the second and glorious coming again. Tassa ecton sun, si prosferumen kata panda, ke dia panda. Beseech thee and pray and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit. So that they may be to those who receive them for the purification of the soul, for the remission of sins, for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, and for the boldness to approach thee, neither unto judgment nor unto condemnation. Again, we offer unto thee this reasonable worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Ξουρέτος της Παναγίας ακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσπίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αϊπάρθενου Μαρία.
Thank you. Χριστίστητη Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου ημών Νικολάου, ον χάρις έτσι Αγίας Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνη ίσον εν ημώνια μερκμερεύοντα και ορθού του μόντο των λόγων της εις αληθείας και ον έχαστος κατά διάνοια ρέχει και πάντων και πάσων. And grant us that with one mouth and one heart we may glorify and praise the now honorable and majestic name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. In the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with you all. Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For these precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our merciful God, who hath received them on his holy and celestial and invisible altar unto a scent of spiritual fragrance, may send down upon us divine grace, the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Την ενότητα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος ετισάμενοι αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμέθα. Και κατεξίωσον ημάς Δέσποτε με την Παρησία σε κατακρίτως τόλμαν επικαλείστε σε τον επουράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγει Πάτερ ημών που εν της ουρανής αγιαστεί το όνομά σου έλθε το η βασιλεία σου γεννηθεί το θέλημά σου ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης τον άρτον ημών των ιεπιούσιων δώσει μην σήμερον και άφηση μην τα οφλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφίεμεν σε φιλέτσις ημών, και εμείς δεν έγκεις ημάς πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσε ημάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Ότι σου εστιν η βασιλεία και η δύναμις και η δόξα του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Peace be with you. Bow our heads unto the Lord. Through the grace and mercy and love for mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Της Αγίας, the holy gifts unto the holy. Μιλήσετε και ενημερίζετε όμως ότι μιλήσετε ο πάντοτες αιώνας.
Με τα φόβο Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσέλθετε.
Pedelavani o dulos to Thu. Servant of God. Servant of God. Office of Martion, Kesuin, Union, Amin. Servant of God. For life everlasting. Servant of God. Ioannis. For the mission of his center for life everlasting. Servant of God. Ioannis is communed for the mission of his sin, for life everlasting. Servant of God, he has communed for the mission of his sin, for life everlasting. Servant of God, John is communed for the mission of his sin, for life everlasting. Servant of God, everlasting. Servant of God, the mission of his sins for life everlasting. Servant of God, Maria is communed for the mission of her sins for life everlasting. Servant of God, Iacobos is communed for the mission of his sins for life everlasting. Servant of God, George is communed for the mission of his sin, for life everlasting. Servant of God, Olivius is communed for the mission of his sin, for life everlasting.
So, son of Theos, the lawns who gave lawyers on the clear of me and so.
We have seen the light of true life.
πάντοτεν ειν και αεί, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ, worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having asked the Lord that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Ούτε εσύ ο Αγιός μας ημών και εσύ την δόξαν εν απέμπωμεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Εν ειρήνη προέρθωμεν του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύλεσον, 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 Πατέρα Υιέ, ευλόγησον.
Lord, blesses those and bless thee and sanctify those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Protect the whole body of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy temple. Do thou and glorify them by the divine power and forsake not us who set our hope in thee. Grant peace to the world, to the churches, to the priests, to the civil authorities, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For all good giving and every perfect gift is from above coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And to thee we ascribe glory and thanksgiving and worship to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from henceforth and forevermore.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, των Αγίων ο χορός ευρεπιήν τη ζωής και θύραν παραδείσου ευρωχαγώ. Την οδόν δια της μετανοίας, το πολλολός προδατών εγώ ημί, ανακάλεσε με σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, ανάπασον. Ο Θεός τους δούλους σου και κατάταξον αυτούς εν παραδείσο, όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δικαίοι εκλάψου συνοφωστήρες, τους και κοιμημένους δούλους σου ανάβαξον, παρορών αυτών πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The tribunions of the God at singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, co-beginningless Son, and Holy Spirit. Shine upon us who in faith worship you and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Δις γένος των ανθρώπων εύρατο την σωτηρία, δια σου εμβριμέν παράδεισον, Θεοτό και αγνή ευλογημένη.
Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο
Θεός. Αλληλούια, αλληλούια, δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Αλληλούια, αλληλούια, αλληλούια.
Το πνευμά των δικαίων τετελειωμένων, τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου σώτερν άπαυσον, φυλά των αυτάς εις την μακαριάν σου είναι η παρασύ φιλάνθρωπε.
Μασίν σου Κύριε, όπου πάντες οι Άγιοι σου αναπαύονται, αναπαύσον Κύριε, και τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου, ότι μόνος υπάρχεις αθάνατο.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You are God who descended into Hades and ended the suffering of all who were in prison. O Savior, also rest the souls of these your servants.
Πρέσβευε υπέρ του ελεηθήνε τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy. Again, we pray for the repose of the souls of the servants of God, Panagia, Nicholas, and Michael, who have fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all their errors, both voluntary and involuntary, that the Lord God will place their souls where the righteous rest and will grant to them mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord. O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death, crushed the power of the devil, and granted life to your world, you yourself, O Lord, give rest to the souls of these your servants, Panagia, Nicholas, and Michael, who have fallen asleep in a place of light, a place of green pasture, a place of repose, where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which they have committed in word or deed or thought, for your good God who loves mankind, for there is no one who lives and does not sin. Only you are without sin, your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Let us pray to the Lord. For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servants, Panagia, Nicholas, and Michael, who have fallen asleep, O Christ our God, and to you we ascribe glory, together with the beginningless Father and your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Εωνιάσιμ νημιάξο μακάριστη καμνίστη αδελφοί ημών. Εωνιάσιμ νημιάξο μακάριστη καμνίστη αδελφοί ημών. Everlasting be your memory, who are worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Amen. Kyrie eleison.
Ευλογία Κύριου και ελέος αυτού ελθύ μας, τι αυτού θεία χάριτη και φιλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Δόξα σε ο Θεός, ελπίσιμον Κύριε δόξα σε.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλογήσον.
Ο εν εγκάλες του δικαίου Σημειών βασιστηκθήνε κατά δεξάμενος δια την ημών σωτηρίαν και αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός ο Μητρός Θεός ημών τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και Παναμώμα Αγίας αυτού Μητρός δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Εζώπιου Σταυρού προστασίας του Τιμίου Ροπρανίων δυνάμενων σωμάτων ηγεσίας του Τιμίου ενδόξου προφήτου προδρόμου και βαπτιστού Ιωάννου των Αγίων ενδόξων και επαναφήμων Αποστόλων, των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών και μεγάλων εικών και μικρών δασκάλων, των Αγίων Πατρός ημών Ιωάννου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινοπόλεως του Χρυσοστόμου, των Αγίων ενδόξων και καλλινίκων μαρτύρων, των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώρων Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, των Αγίων Ισιδόρου και Νικολάου των Οσίων, Ιωσήφ, νεομάρτυρος και πάντων των Αγίων ελέησε και σώσε εμάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελέημον Θεός. Διευχών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Σου Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον εμάς. Η Αγία Τριάστη φυλάξε πάντας εμάς. Καλημέρα σας.
Thank you.
Good morning. As we entered the month of February, that usually means that we are about to enter Great and Holy Lent as well. And with Pascha so early this year, we are just a few weeks out from the start of our Great Lent. This coming Tuesday, we celebrate on February 6th the Feast of St. Phocis. And on Thursday, February 8th, is the Feast of St. Theodore. And Saturday is the first Saturday of the Souls, of which there are three on three successive Saturdays. The first one will take place this coming Saturday on the 10th of February. All of those services will begin at 8:30 with the Orthodox, 9:30 Divine Liturgy. Tuesdays and Thursdays services will be in our St. Catherine's Chapel. And Saturdays, Saturday of the Souls, Divine Liturgy, of course, will be upstairs in the main church. Following the distribution of Andidero this morning, we will be hosting our stewardship brunch, and there's information in the bulletin about that, so we hope that you'll be able to stay for about an hour or so afterwards and enjoy the brunch that's been prepared for us. Next Sunday, our Sunday church school hosts its Godparent Sunday on February 11th, and they will be hosting as well a luncheon. There is a flyer in the bulletin announcing that as well. And later in the day, on February 11th, is the Apocriatico Glendi on Meat Fair Sunday. There is a flyer in the bulletin as well concerning the times and the price on that as well. So there are a number of activities prior to the start of Great Lent towards the end of this month. So you can refer to the bulletin for that and other information. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. There are only a few stories in all the world's literature that are as well known or identifiable as the one we heard this morning in our gospel reading. And this morning's reading was the gospel of the parable of the prodigal son. And rightly so. There is no portrait of God and his infinite love and mercy in any of the world's other religions more meaningful than this gospel story which we listen to. This parable, in addition to being called Sunday of the Prodigal Son, we can also call it the parable of the waiting father. And this passage actually is one of three very quick parables that are found in the 15th chapter of St. Luke's Gospel. And if you were to take some time and read St. Luke's Gospel, specifically chapter 15, you would find Jesus using analogies to describe his message, similar to the message this morning. The first passage in this chapter speaks about a lost sheep. The second one is about a lost coin. And the third is about our story that we listened to this morning, a lost son. Some of you, in fact, may have seen this very story played out in your own families. Perhaps a son, or a daughter, a brother, an uncle, someone in the family who for a while becomes lost to the family. Alcohol or drugs, a need to escape home. It's an old, old story, but
probably there isn't a family that hasn't experienced something like this. Or even maybe you yourself were once a prodigal. Maybe you still are. In our hearts, all of us are prodigals to one degree or another. Or we are the elder brother, the other character in this morning's gospel reading, who was so self-righteous and hurt because the father, he felt, treated the wayward son better. But that's human nature. That's why this familiar story strikes home as it does. And certainly, we all know the story. It begins with the first few verses of the 15th chapter of St. Luke. And listen as I read them. Now, the tax collectors and sinners were all gathering around to hear Jesus speak. But the Pharisees and the teachers of the law muttered, "This man welcomes sinners and has the audacity to eat with them." Now, St. Luke, in his gospel passage, sets the scene masterfully. Tax collectors and sinners were gathering around on this day to hear Jesus. And as we know, tax collectors were universally despised by the righteous and the unrighteous alike. Why? Because they had close ties to the government of Rome. And they used despicable means of securing their income. If you recall, last Sunday we read a story about a similar situation of the publican and the Pharisee, another tax collector who had gone astray. And Jesus tells us in this parable this morning, with a particular audience in mind. As we heard, a man had two sons, and there was a remarkable contrast between the two boys. The younger of the sons was restless, while the other boy was more conforming. He was compliant to the wishes of the family. And there's nothing really shocking about that, as siblings are not always alike, are they? But the younger boy does something that is indeed shocking. One day he comes to his father and he says, "Father, give me my share of the inheritance." Now normally, just as we see many times today, an estate was not divided and given to the heirs until the father was very old and could not manage anymore, or perhaps after he was dead. The younger son's request was therefore seen as an act of rebellion. He was committing a grave sin in making such a request. Requesting his share of the father's estate early was a radical act by the younger boy. But the father's response, the father's act, was even more radical. Jesus says simply, "So the father consented and divided his property between the two boys." The father let his young wayward son have his way. The son's request surely hurt his father. It bruised his heart, but he let his son go. And as we heard in our gospel reading this morning, the younger son gathered his belongings and inheritance and went off into a far land, away from his father's house. And St. Luke tells us he proceeded to squander his money in wild and loose living. It was party time all the time. And he was living it up until the money finally ran out and all the fun ended. We are told that the younger son had no alternative than to get a job. And the only job he could find was feeding pigs on a farm. Now, to us today, that may not sound like a big deal, though not exactly a desirable type of employment. But to Jews, swine were considered unclean. No Jew would take this job willingly. But this boy was desperate, so desperate that he even considered eating the slop that was fed to the pigs. And we heard in our gospel reading this morning, finally St. Luke says this boy came to his senses. He said, "How many of my father's hired servants have food to spare, and here I am starving to death. I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.'" And so, with his tail between his legs, as the cliche goes, he starts home. And then something extraordinary happens. St. Luke says, "But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him, and kissed him." And the wayward son began his carefully rehearsed speech about how sorry he is. But the father isn't even listening to the son. He's too busy giving his servants orders. "Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is now found." So, says St. Luke, they then began to celebrate. We are told that the father welcomed him back without condition, unconditionally. The gospel reads, "After seeing him from afar, the father had compassion on him and ran and embraced him and kissed him." And the son started his words of confession. "Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son." But the father stopped him, and he didn't even give him the opportunity to finish this carefully prepared speech. And as I said, the father turned and said to his servants, "Bring quickly the best robe and put it on him." Now, there were reasons for this. In those days, the robe was a symbol of honor. "And put a ring on his hand." The ring was a symbol of authority. "And put shoes, sandals on his feet." The meaning here, slaves went barefoot, sons of rulers wore shoes. "And kill the fatted calf." Meaning in the ancient world, there was no possibility of preserving meat. So when guests came, the animal was killed that could be eaten by all the guests. The fact that a fatted calf was killed signified that the father was saying that this was an event for the whole village to celebrate, the return home of his son. But there was an even further significance in the killing of the fatted calf. The actual slaughter of the animal would take place where? It would take place in front of the doorway of the home, when the guest would then step across the blood of the animal that had been slain. It symbolized something. It was a sign that the past had been left behind, and there was a new covenant or a new relationship between the host and the guest. And as the son stepped over the blood of the animal that had been slain, it was a sign of his father's total and complete acceptance and forgiveness. The father welcomed him back unconditionally. Now, some of us may think that the boy didn't deserve that kind of reception. Many who heard Jesus tell the story were surely offended that a boy who treated his father so should get off scot-free. Their discomfort is reflected in the envy of the elder brother that we heard about. He had stayed home all these years, and yet the father never killed the fatted calf for him. And finally, that brings us to our situation. You and I, as Christians and followers of Christ, what about us? How far does our forgiveness go? How long do we carry on our petty arguments and grudges and pouts of ignoring people who are not talking to our neighbor? We spoke last week on last Sunday's gospel reading, where the theme was humility, the humility of the publican versus the pride of the Pharisee. And today the theme is one of forgiveness. How many of us know how to forgive? I don't mean forgiving the people that you like, that's easy. I mean to forgive someone who has wronged you, someone who's abused you, someone who's mistreated you, or maybe you mistreated someone. How many of us know what it is to accept our brother and sister with all of their faults and not be judgmental? My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, that is what these gospel readings of the last two Sundays are all about. Humility and forgiveness. Unconditional humility and unconditional forgiveness. If you say, yes, Father, but, then you've missed the true message of these last two gospels, because you put conditions on your humility and on your forgiveness. The church speaks to us about grace. It is about love, which is interested more in redemption than judgment. Most of the problems in this world are caused by people who do not really know that in order to be accepted, they must learn to love. This morning's gospel, just like most of the other gospels, speak continually about love. When you are able to love in the true Christian sense, you will, in effect, be acting in a humble manner. And as a result, you will be able to forgive and accept and tolerate the bad along with the good. Our love, my dear friends, must be unconditional. That's the love that Christ gives us, as our Heavenly Father always is eager to forgive us unconditionally. Earthly fathers may be tempted to kill the prodigal son, but the eternal Father kills rather the fatted calf to rejoice in the return of the son who was lost but now is alive again. Amen.